Swamps, bogs, marshes, quagmires, fens, bayous, moors, mires, you name it, all low-lying wetlands with biome-defining powers. These damp and mushy forested areas are the breeding grounds for all sorts of life forms, and of course, all sorts of scary stories. People tend to dislike goopy, grabby earth and places with lots of bugs. Plus, anything that lives below any swampy surface can't be trusted, and as such should be avoided at all costs. For ages, legends have been passed down of human creatures rising from the muck and inhuman beasts skittering along the surfaces, along with formless freaks festering among the forestry. If it's good enough for an ogre, it's good enough for a bunch of other mythical monsters. What are you doing in my swamp? Hello, horror heads, and welcome back to the scariest channel on YouTube, Top 5 Scary Videos. I'm your horror host, Keegan Hughes, and today we are wading waist deep into some swampy waters of yore. These are the top 5 scary swamp stories that will give you nightmares. Before we get started, make sure to give this video a brackish thumbs up and subscribe for more slimy swamp stuff. Let's get going. Coming in at number 5, the ghosts of Bayou Sail Road. Of course, we are going to start off with a swamp story from Louisiana. The bayou is a classic location for ghosts and ghouls to haunt anyone who enters the steamy, sweaty wetland. Many consider Bayou Sail Road to be the most haunted street in the state, which is really saying something considering the amount of stories and superstitions that originate in this jazz haven. One of the most famous stories is about a hitchhiker who wanders the roadside waiting for motorists to notice him. First and foremost, haunted place plus hitchhiker equals dead traveler. It's simple math, folks. If you slow down to pick him up, it's likely he will just turn transparent and disappear, though. However, some have reported that he has made requests of passing drivers before. What does he ask for? Treasure, or the soul of a passenger. There aren't too many drivers who would be willing to hand over either of these things to a hitchhiking haint, so we're not so sure what happens if you oblige. There's another story on this road detailing a ghostly woman following cars, hands outstretched. She appears to be attempting to touch the car, or maybe the people inside. Either way, you probably don't want her getting her ghostly grip on you or the vehicle. On top of these tales, many drivers report seeing the faces of spirits floating by and feeling an engulfing presence that makes their skin crawl. Unless you have to make the trip from Dulac to Cocodrie, I would avoid this road altogether. Filling out our number 4 spot, we have the Frenchtown Road Cult. This one's a little less ghostly and a little more gruesome. Usually cults are bad news, but when one takes up residency in a deep, dank, swampy forest, you definitely want to steer clear. Frenchtown Road has now been assimilated into the Frenchtown Road Conservation Area, but it used to be a popular location to visit with the express purpose of getting spooked. The forest becomes so dense as you drive along, it almost seems like the trees are closing in on you, choking you, crushing you. If you make it deep enough without chickening out, you'll come across an old train trestle covered with old graffiti and arcane symbols. This is the point where many people will give up and head back, but intrepid adventurers might want to take a closer look. Satanic symbols, demonic sigils, and indecipherable crests cover the boards and posts. These signs lead people to believe that satanic cults gather in the surrounding areas, waiting for the perfect sacrifices to stumble right into their grasp. Many folks claim that they watch visitors from the sides of the road, hiding in the surrounding swamps. People travel too far, it's said that the cults will snatch them up and slay them if they're deemed worthy of ritual slaughter. There are stories of targets being hung from the train trestle, adding to the collection of ghosts and spirits that now take residence in the area. Cults, ghosts, and suffocating flora? Definitely a road you don't want to take. Coming in at number 3, we've got bog bodies. We'll take a quick trip out of Louisiana for this one and take in some international swamp scares. Bog bodies have actually been discovered in peat bogs all over the world, often by accident. Just imagine working for a peat moss harvester and going about your job, cutting up moss, hauling it out, and then all of a sudden, bam, centuries old dead body brushes up against your leg. The bog would probably get a little swampier, if you know what I mean. These unfortunate souls end up naturally mummified and preserved in the depths of peat bogs all over the place. These bogs have near miraculous preservative qualities, and folks left at the bottom are so well pickled that when they're exhumed, most of their bodies are still intact. This is true even thousands of years down the line. Because they have been so well taken care of, these corpses are basically windows into the past. Often their last meals are still sitting in their stomachs, and their clothes are in relatively good shape. Or as good shape as anything can be after sitting at the bottom of a peat bog for centuries. Any injuries these folks may have sustained are preserved as well, often pointing to how they died. In fact, many people who founded bogs were killed quite violently. Common injuries are wrung necks, slit throats, bashed in heads, broken limbs, and general blunt force trauma. These common traits have led many to believe that some bog bodies were human sacrifices made to appease the bog gods. Not the nicest way to go, huh? Sacrificed and drowned in the thick, peaty goodness of the bog. Without a proper burial or even the ability to decompose, you can bet that these ghosts are none too happy. Slotting in at number 2, the Rougarou. Let's head back to Louisiana for some more Bayou baddies. A local favorite, the Rougarou is known as the Louisiana Wolfman. Adapted from the French word for werewolf, Lougarou, this Creole creature roams the bayous in southeastern Louisiana. The legend works more or less the same as the classic werewolf, with the curse granting shape-shifting powers and a thirst for blood, among other things. Of course, if you get attacked by a Rougarou, it's likely you'll become one as well. Common stories associated with these lycanthropic Louisianans include the kidnapping of misbehaving children and the turning of Catholics who don't observe Lent. The curse can be transferred to someone else by having them cut you and draw blood, which passes the wolfman mania onto them. But good luck finding someone who's willing to carry that burden for you, though. If you want to avoid the Rougarou altogether, you better behave. Listen to your parents, and observe Lent. There are also some methods of keeping it at arm's length, though. Placing 13 objects outside of your house supposedly works, as these beasts are none too good at math and can only count to 12. Confuses them when they see 13. It's kind of a strange technique, but hey, if it works, it works. And finally at number 1, Voodoo Priestess Julie White. When I die, I'm taking you all with me. A pretty terrifying promise, wouldn't you say? Well, it's one that this reclusive voodoo priestess intended on keeping. Julie White was a famous practitioner of the voodoo arts throughout her life. She could be found hanging out on the porch of her swamp shack, predicting the demise of surrounding towns. White would make arcane gestures at people passing by, giving the evil eye, singing songs about the day of her death, and cursing anyone who dared to cross her. Even though she was feared, she was also seen and respected as a potent oracle. Many looked to her predictions as signs of impending doom and misfortune. This made it all the more terrifying when she began chanting about her own death. On a day close to her own demise, the priestess began chanting, "When I die, I'm taking you all with me," over and over and over again. After she did die, her funeral was well attended, with many locals coming out to pay their respects, or maybe to ensure that they weren't cursed by her in the afterlife. However, on the day of her funeral, a hurricane swept through. A tidal wave was reported to have crashed down upon the funeral, unceremoniously burying her and everyone else in attendance in a mass grave somewhere else in the swamp. To this day, many of the bodies still remain lodged in the muck and mire. Occasionally, a body will float up to the top and freak out the locals, and some say that the voices of the dead, as well as ghastly apparitions of White herself, still haunt the swamp to this day. Her ghost is heard still repeating the strange, eerie chant, and visitors report hearing strange wailing and screaming. A local legend even claims that she left a hex that led to the collapse of the Manchac Bridge, although the bridge built in its place is yet to fall. Only time will tell if the hex is staying power beyond what was previously imagined. Does this change any of your swamp-related vacation plans? There are a lot more swamp hauntings than one would expect, huh? What do you think is the scariest swamp story this side of the bayou? Let me know down in the comments. Speaking of comments, let's take a look at some of your more ghastly ones from last time. Ben Trimble says, "Keegan, I'd suggest not wearing that deer shirt if you ever go into the woods." Well, why not? Being targeted by hunters and predators alike adds an extra layer of challenge to your wooded walk. The No Jay says, "I have an exceptionally hard time trusting a creature whose primary source of locomotion is undulation." You and me both, brother. If you undulate, stay the hell away from me and my family. Scorpion Rock says, "I was today years old when I discovered the Spinosaurus wasn't just invented for Jurassic Park 3. It does seem like a beast that would just be dreamed up to fight the T-Rex, eh? I could see it being like a playable character in like an old Rampage game too." Marshall Mars says, "Actually, it's pronounced Gigantosaurus." Did I get it right? Thank you for the correction. I won't always get it perfect, but I'm glad we've got experts in the comments making sure that misinformation does not spread. And Nick Lipscomb says, "Doing well, Keegan, but stick to one unit of measure, dude." I know. It hurts to use anything other than the metric system, but with an international audience and sources from all over the place, even I can get confused from time to time. And that's all the time we have for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.
We should be good for about 20 seconds until it starts up again.
Yep, so we'll get one sentence, and pause, start again. 20. Not that many people in today, so you know, we got lots of time. Yeah, there it is. And welcome back to another episode of the Scariest. I hear the saw again.
Yeah, this is the intro, Scary. I guess go from
the top
of
Hello, horror heads, and welcome back to another episode of the Scariest channel on YouTube. Does that make sense? Welcome back to another episode? I should just say welcome back to... You don't want to hear my Shrek impression again?
I think you nailed it.
There aren't too many drivers who'd be willing to hand over either of those to this... Adapted from the French war... This Creole creature sometimes roams the bayous in southern...
I'm just making things up on the spot, apparently. I read the script and you can
stumble over your words. Listen to your parents and observe Lent. These are some... It hurts to... Saw...